tomorrow, checking our water. We've been doing quite well lately. 155 million gallons is the target. The actual, 133 million gallons. And looking at our extended forecast, 64 for tomorrow and partly cloudy. Then, again, some rain showers perhaps Friday night, early Saturday. Starting to clear out a bit, though, by Saturday afternoon. And then nice on Sunday, 70, and a little bit of warming to trend early next week, starting on the latter half of your weekend. And our weather picture from Marty from Lawton Elementary in Seattle. A nice picture of a wild thunder shower and a little bit of rain and some wild clouds as well. And, you know, if you're thinking about fishing, we got a great fishing tip. You don't want to forget, you've got to take care of your gear. And Dr. Tioki, our fishing expert, tells us all about it. Doc, what's up?
Larry, so many times fishermen have lost big fish at the boat because of poor rod and reel maintenance. My hot fishing tip for this week, check those rods and reels. Check for cracks or splits in your eye guides, particularly the tip of the rod. Next, go to the reel. Lubricate all the moving parts to make sure that the line comes off the reel evenly. This is Dr. Tioki reminding you, loosen the drag on your reel when you put it away.
Thank you, Doc. That's it. That's all.
Nothing's worse than a draggy reel, I gotta tell you.
That's right. But no surprises tomorrow, we hope. And, taking a look now at our extended forecast, partly sunny again tomorrow. That'll be Friday, of course. And then for the weekend, we're looking at cloudy skies on Saturday, and the days are messed up a little bit there. So we're going to go cloudy skies on Saturday, and a slight chance of some rain, and then partly sunny on Sunday. So things look like a split decision over the weekend. All right. Emmy Rosera from Bellingham has this fine picture of a sun setting with, well, it looks like the beach there, the ocean, and a couple of people walking on the beach. Isn't that a fine picture? All righty. If you're thinking about doing a little fishing, Dr. Tioki, our fishing expert, has a tip for you this weekend.
Larry, there's a lot of purse seining going on in Puget Sound right now. I'm off of Southworth, working around a lot of purse seiners. I'm trying to catch a couple of fish myself. Just a word of caution for you fishermen out here that are going in Clovis Passage, watch out for these nets. Other than that, I'm going to say fish on. I'm going to try to catch one amongst these purse seiners.
Cast for tonight. Expect clear sky. It's going to be a warm night. Temperatures will bottom out tomorrow morning between the upper 50s and lower 60s, 60 for Seattle, 59 in Olympia. And then tomorrow, you'll get up, the sun will be shining brightly, and the temperatures by the time you get to work, it'll be in the upper 60s, low 70s. By lunchtime, it'll be in the 80s, or near 80s, approaching 80 anyway, and by late afternoon, as you're heading back out of work, near 90 degrees, 92 for Seattle, 93 in Tacoma, 94 in Olympia, eastern Washington, upper 90s to near 100 degrees. So, in a word, or make that three words, hot, hot, hot. And our water? Yeah, well, our water's been near the targets or slightly below. Our extended forecast, Thursday, Friday, Saturday now, temperatures in the lower 90s. Be careful of the heat. Drink fluids. Try to stay out of the heat of the middle of the day. Some cooling on Sunday, Seafair fans, but not much, just into the lower 80s. That's still well above normal. Here's our hot fishing tip from Dr. Tioki, fishing expert of Puget Sound, from Point Defiance to about the Tacoma Narrows Bridge. They are biting in the evening, bite in about 145 feet of water, a number two glow flasher, from what I understand, and that's where they's biting. Give it a try.
They's biting. Okay, thanks.
More clouds then. And don't forget our KSTW Courage Classic, September 12th through the 14th. If you want more information, call 1-800-39-CYCLE, and we'll get you all the information you need. It's quite a challenge up there. All right, remember last night we gave you a fishing tip? Well, this one really panned out. Take a look this morning, just off Point Defiance, just a few miles away from where I'm standing. Yes, indeed. We got a big one. It was about 38-pound salmon, and they were biting pretty good this morning off Point Defiance in about 145 feet of water, and it looks like another fine bite. You want to take a look
That's
at
a nice
what
one.
These things look like? There were a couple of big salmon. One was about 22 pounds. The other one was 38 pounds, and so they were a couple of big fish as, well, I guess we won't get a look at those. There, here we go. There they are. Is that incredible? There's Dr. T. Hokey. He gave us the hot tip, and the doctor has got another hot fishing tip for you coming up this weekend. Here it is.
I would fish in this area of Point Defiance. Now the fish are starting to show up in the South Sound area. Also Point Evans, but I'd hit that on an evening incoming tide. If you're up north around Seattle, you might want to try Shilshil Bay Marina, but concentrate on early morning bites, and like I said, work with and across the current. That's critical.
Yes, indeed. I think I got the big one here. Ho, ho, ho. Yes, that's flapping all around. Oh, yes, indeed. Oh, yes, the typical, it's the boot trick, and there it is. Oh, well, I don't have a license anyway, and I need one because that's all I could get. Don, Kim?
Keep trying, Larry. Yeah, keep Maybe they'll start biting.
Maybe you'll catch the other boot.
Except I need a pair.
Moving on.